89? Give me a number. 0706.
5 p.m. Saturday.
48.
The day before Paul McCartney opens.
Give me a number.
Production manager Chris Lamb and his crew arrive at Chicago's O'Hare Airport. And this...
75. What's the first digit?
...is the least of his worries.
We got a lot of people in Chicago waiting to see a show.
Numbers.
We run tight. Run very tight.
00.
Lamb has to meet a deadline.
12 midnight we're rigging. 6 a.m. I've got lights coming in. 9 a.m. I've got the carpenters coming in along with projection and lasers. Sound at 10, banger at 1.
He has only 16 hours to set up McCartney's multi-million dollar stage.
I'm carrying 46 men.
10 truck drivers.
On the road with me.
5 carpenters.
I hire another. I'm missing a man. 50 union stagehands.
7 sound men.
I've got one of the best road crews out.
32 feet.
515 is what you're making.
It's got to be right here.
For Paul McCartney, when he walks on that stage...
4,200 pounds.
It needs to be identically the same every day.
It's got to be flush.
As long as he feels comfortable and confident with his stage, then the only thing he's concerned with is giving a good performance to his audience.
Yeah, downstage again for this one.
Downstage is good.
We're real safety conscious of this stuff out here.
Go! Tell me about your grid that you're going to put up here. How much weight are you actually putting up in the air?
With all of the lighting and the sound and everything up there, we'll be hanging about 32 tons.
32 tons? That's a lot of weight.
Yeah.
Of course, you got Paul McCartney who's going to be standing under it. You've got to do it right, huh?
Paul McCartney or anybody, really. I'm standing under it, too.
Well, Chris, it's 7 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
Every truck come in accounted for? You got
all the trucks are here. We unloaded 4 last night. We have 6 more to go.
When do you sleep again?
After the show tonight.
Oh, you'll stay up all the way?
Yeah. I drink a lot of coffee and smoke too many cigarettes. I have some more of my lighting people arriving now.
What number is that that's bouncing, Lauren?
12 o'clock and we don't have a speaker in the air.
This is the one that was used on the last Beatles tour. Probably the most valuable instrument I've ever touched.
These guys are different. In another era, they'd have been cowboys, or they'd have been pirates.
No one knows, no one really cares who these guys are, their names, their faces, anything else.
I'm just cleaning up microphones so they don't smell nasty.
Number one guitar he uses throughout most of the show.
Everybody's still nervous about each gig, you know? We're all anticipating any problem might arise. We want it to be perfect every night.
All set?
What kind of toll does this job take on you and your men?
How long until we go up to testing height?
A lot of people think it's a glamorous type of job and it's hanging out with rock stars and things.
So we can go up to testing height in about 10 minutes?
But you give up your personal life. We travel, we work hard. A lot of the guys have left wives, family, everything else at home, and you leave them at home for anywhere between a month to 6 months. It's tough because the only free time a lot of these guys have is late at night. And late at night, you got a choice of going to sit in your hotel room or down to the bar.
I was convinced I wouldn't be touring when I was, you know, over 30, and I'm 35 and I'm still doing it.
There is a heavy emotional toll, yeah. My own marriage has just fallen apart, for want of a better word. It happens to a lot of us. It's one of the diseases of the job.
Chicago!
As far as the bodyguards are concerned, it is not only rock and roll.
We're going to be the lead car.
It's much more serious than that.
I'm supposed to go to 435 North Michigan.
They know, as we all do now, what can happen to the rich and famous, especially if only yesterday you were one of the Beatles.
Call for my kids, please. Okay, they love you.
Paul McCartney is back.
You're a lot bigger in real life.
I'm bigger.
Yeah.
I'm huge, man.
He's on the road again with a new band.
It's all right, dog. Take it easy.
That includes his wife, Linda.
I thought we were in Germany, but it turns out we're not.
Wir sind in Chicago.
Oh, Chicago. I saw a man dance with his wife.
They have the time of their life.
The Beatles are the number one recording group of all time.
Yeah.
Only Elvis had more top 40 hits.
Oh, hey,
great, man.
But McCartney hasn't had a number one song in 6 years. And the cold fact is, A lot of the pop world wrote him off.
Is there a tape cassette recorder in here?
Probably just up there.
Oh, yeah, I got it. Yeah.
But he's got a new album out now, and the critics like it.
And now the build-up before the gig begins. The press conference first, and then the gig itself.
They've already played a few cities in Europe, and they've begun a cross-country U.S. tour to promote the new album. And if things work out, to reestablish Paul McCartney as a major force in pop music for the 1990s.
Big Mac truck. Big Mac truck. Here we are, guys. Tense up.
There it is. There it goes.
McCartney's new release, Flowers in the Dirt, has already gone gold.
Excuse me, sir.
500,000 sales.
Thank you. Close, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, here we go.
And they're hoping the tour will push it to platinum. 1 million albums.
Take my cassette and go. So what's the gig?
Besides all the traveling and all the concerts,
work.
There's also, the record isn't the only thing McCartney is pushing. Celebrity has also given him a forum.
Paul, this is Dave McBride from Q101.
Hi, Dave. Nice to meet you.
For his message.
I, like a lot of other people, want to see a lot of the pollution stopped. I want to see this hole in the ozone layer stopped so I can go back sunbathing. We want to live in a clean world, yo.
And it's just a profession.
But you've seen the...
Is there something you haven't heard that you're wondering, why hasn't anybody asked me that?
There's little areas that I know and that I know people don't kind of know about. Well, the trouble is I end up sounding like I'm trying to justify myself, which I don't like. But there's a bit of a feeling about that kind of John was really the sort of only avant-garde one in the Beatles.
But you know, in a way, let me be blunt, time has been better to him in some ways than you, and I don't want to be cold about this, but John is dead. Death comes a certain amount of sympathy.
Well, exactly, that's the thing, and that's really the danger. And I think, you know, John would be the first person to not say he was the only guy in the Beatles or he was the major talent. I never ever heard him suggest that to anyone.
Well, it's been...
But as you say, you know, when a person dies, they tend to get martyred.
Does it bother you?
I've seen one or two things that have kind of said, you know, John was the Beatles, and these other guys just backed him up. That bothers me, because it's just not true. Certainly all the stuff I sing tonight, John didn't really have much of a hand in. I pretty much got to leave that for people to find out. You know, if I start coming on heavy and trying to say, hey, you know, I was just as important as John was, it's very unseemly.
With death, in some cases, comes martyrdom.
Comes a sort of eulogy, which is good. I mean, you know, why not? You know, he was a great guy. As he said himself, if there's such a thing as a genius, I am one.
Does it surprise you, the power of the legend today?
Yeah, I mean, it does surprise me because, you know, really, we were just kids hoping to make a break out of Liverpool, and it turned into something much more important, really. What doesn't surprise me is the fact that it's kind of lasted, because John and I put in a lot of work, man, on those songs. I mean, we were really, really keen to emulate the songwriters that we loved. Mm-hmm. I mean, I was out to become like another Cole Porter. Still am, babe.
Hey, guys, we're all right there. I'll see you in a bit. We're gonna do a sound check, right? We're looking to see if we can find just what part of the building the sound checks are done in. Is he coming to do one of the this afternoon? He could be. You guys don't say a word. That's right. Okay, security, that's right, that's fine, that's all right. He hasn't been around here though. This is private property right now. Okay, well, I don't think he's here.
Not here. I guarantee.
I gotta have it.
You
have
it tonight, or?
Yeah, tonight.
How many shows are you going to?
One here and one in New York next weekend.
Okay.
I went to two in L.A.
It's from Dallas.
Just really, this gives you chills.
When he does Back in the U.S.A., the place goes nuts.
Not Back in the U.S.A.
Yeah. Oh. The place goes nuts, and then after he does that, he goes right into, well, she was just crazy. The place goes crazy. But the best is the encore. The best.
What's the encore?
What's that?
No.
T-minus.
We're getting the final preparations for a sound check right now.
You on schedule, Chris?
Yeah.
Two.
Still worried?
Yeah.
Still worried?
Always.
Does it surprise you? The power of the legend today. Well, welcome all.
Welcome all. Yeah, I mean, it does surprise me because, you know, really we were just kids hoping to make a break out of Liverpool, and it turned into something much more important, really. What doesn't surprise me is the fact that it's kind of lasted, because John and I put in a lot of work, man, on those songs. I mean, we were really, really keen to emulate the songwriters that we loved. Mm-hmm. I mean, I was out to become like another Cole Porter. Still am, babe.
On the sound purely.
How's that other mic? Okay? He wants to do his perfect show up there. I want to do mine down here.
Yeah! Yeah, we're in good shape. Just another one of those long days. Let the sun catch you right over you. I never dreamt I'd be even in this business, much less working for the man who started it all.
They don't get much bigger than this.
No, you can't go much bigger. It's not like we have to become famous or we want to be famous, but we know in ourselves what we've done. And at the end of the night, when you get that big applause, that's for us too.
Minutes, Tony, roll film.
Oh, yeah.
30 minutes.
Oh, yeah. All right, let's go.
Yeah. You know what the crew calls you?
Don't ask. No.
Some of them call you Dad.
Dad? That's
said,
cool.
In L.A., they said Dad was doing well tonight. You're only 47, which is a young man, obviously, but...
All right, lads, that's us all checked out.
You know what the crew calls you?
Don't ask. No.
Some of them call you Dad.
Dad? That's cool.
In L.A., they said Dad was doing well tonight. You're only 47, which is a young man, obviously, but... How old is too old to be a rock and roll star?
Well, you know, that's the question that keeps getting sort of stretched. The answer gets stretched. We used to think 24 was like it. Yeah. You know, we used to look at 24-year-old guys when we were 18 and think, it's a bit past it, you know. But you get to 30, and then you get to 40, and it doesn't feel bad yet.
Let me ask you a question that I haven't totally thought through. So bear with me on this one.
Another one?
There's something about adulation that interests me. What does that do to you? I mean, does it throw you off at all?
I don't know, really. I always wanted to sing. I always wanted to be on the box, you know, on the telly. I always wanted to be part of what I saw when I was a kid. It wasn't necessarily the adulation or anything. It was just that's what I wanted to do for a kind of job. So you get there and you find people, you know, really sort of screaming and stuff. And it's fun. I'm a married guy. I've got four kids. I'm not about to run off with these girls. Not more than my life's worth.
Not with your wife on stage.
And with a big rolling pin she's got behind that keyboard. No, but I mean, you know, it's just not anything I'm about to do these days. But we keep up this sort of joke, really. To me, it's a bit of a joke. It's a nice joke. They're going, ah! And I'm going, hey, okay. But it's like, no way, Jose. You know, it's not real.
Well, it's a bit of a dry old duple.
Yeah, really sorry, Rog, we don't drink here. It's very hard for me to actually, in my mind, think I am a really famous world star.
Honest?
And these stars are coming to my dressing room.
Like Roger Daltrey of The Who.
You know, for your nut, though.
A nut.
Brazil nut. Brazil nut. I think we kept the Brazil nut from last week in L.A. Just a minute, love. I think the secret is that I don't actually take that on board. Luckily, there's one left.
I've seen people who do, who really take it on board, you know, and I think they're missing the point.
You don't have chauffeured a chauffeur?
No, I don't have a chauffeur.
Home.
We don't have a nanny for the kids. Linda does all the cooking.
Who are you to your kids?
Dad or Paul
McCartney?
I'm Dad, mainly. When they were really little, I was in Scotland once, and the kids were riding past on a little pony, two of them up on a pony. And one of them, four or five, one of them looked at me and said, "You're Paul McCartney."
He pretty much stayed away from Beatles songs after the breakup.
I like that.
Too painful, he says.
That's the one they'll use.
Lolo, Bam and FM, Chicago, 621. We have front row seats for McCartney's sold-out shows at the Rosemont.
An hour before showtime, 14,000 people streaming into the Rosemont horizon. The haves and the have-nots.
Desperate Beatles fan, looking to get in, and I need 2 tickets real bad, and everything has a price I'm willing to pay.
Eager to satisfy that demand, ticket scalpers. Never on the bill, always really working the show.
Anything. Some people are so naive, they go to the park and they pull out $56. They explain to them, it doesn't work like that. No, it's sold out at 100 each.
Everything has a price I'm willing to pay. I'm desperate, I have a heart.
But tonight, the scalpers will have some unexpected customers.
The tickets are going, rumor has it, anywhere between $500 and $600. The guys are going to carry the money. Check your money, make sure you got $400 cash there. I've got the other $400.
Detective Ed Lee and a team of plainclothes officers from the Rosemont Police Department are across the street, preparing to scalp the scalpers.
Let's go to work.
Act Two. A professional scalper melts into the crowd.
Where are they for?
Section 113.
Section one, where's that at, you know?
The first level on the side.
He's shrewd?
Sure, you want to take 75 each.
No way.
He's cagey.
Gotta be 100.
He's?
Under arrest, police department. Put the one in your pocket.
There you go.
Put the one in your pocket. Put it in your pocket.
His name is Tom. He scalps all across the country. Now, he's just been scalped.
The reason I got caught last night, because Paul McCartney's crowd is just too damn old.
Well, these undercovers were obviously of that age, right?
Yeah, I'm saying in this business, rock and roll is for the young, you know what I mean? And basically, you deal with young people. You know a cop.
Oh, man. Hey, the gentleman's from Wisconsin. Came down here with his wife. He has 4 tickets all in a row. He was attempting to recoup what he says he paid for the tickets, even taking a loss at that. I don't think he's a professional ticket scalper. He came too far to only be holding 4 tickets with him. What we're going to do is return all 3 tickets to him. We're not even going to seize the 2.
What are you going to do with the other 2?
You're going to have to eat them.
Can I sell them for $28.50?
$28.50, sure, absolutely.
I'll do that. That's great.
And I'll tell you what.
I need the money.
I'm not the only team out there. If another team catches you, or one person catches you, who's back in here, we're going to charge you to the maximum, because I'm giving you a break.
You got tickets?
Yeah, here.
What do you got, sir?
Doug from Wisconsin is not having a good night.
What do you want for him? $28.50.
That's it?
Yeah, that's what I got sold for.
Where are they at?
17-18.
We're looking for better.
Better seats?
Better seats than that.
I guess. I don't know. Anyway. I've never been here. I thought these were good.
What do you want for him, sir?
$28.50.
Man,
that's a good boy. Thank you.
Good boy.
The couple he just tried to sell his tickets to were, you guessed it, undercover cops. 8:05 p.m. Paul McCartney is about to take the stage. Our man from Wisconsin has had enough. He has decided to take a loss and eat the tickets and leave the scalping to the pros.
It's a great thing for all of us. Promoter got paid, and ordinarily I would have got paid. The cop got paid. Paul McCartney got paid. It's a beautiful world.
Any extra tickets? Any extra tickets?
I got some mezzanines, your 5th row, right on the side of the stage.
Paul McCartney, there it is!
I mean, I'll be a mess, but it's going to be a great mess.
I am so excited, I can't even tell you.
This is almost as good as our wedding.
Yeah, well, wait a minute.
Here we go, Joy, here we go!
All right!
Yay!
All right!
These programs are great. I mean, is that hot or what?
There's no way Paul could disappoint you tonight.
Hold on, George.
Oh, there is no way. No, there is no way he's going to disappoint me tonight. I'll probably have the same reactions I had when I was 14 years old. When the lights go down, you know, it's just going to be, it's going to be great.
Thank you.
Chicago!
Chicago!
be back in the U.S. of A. Going to carry on with a little song that Robbie wrote in the limo on the way here. Check it out. This next song coming up to some friends of ours in the audience tonight, Stella James, Roger, and a lot of other people. It's like this. Tell you what, listen. Before we go any further, I just want to hear everybody in the room go, woo! Thank you. To tell you here, we've had quite a night of it. Before we came on, it was supposed to be like a 14 minute film. The projector bust halfway through. Okay, there's more, wait, there's more. And our drummer Chris was cycling just a couple of days ago, fell off his bike, smashed his face up. So we need your sympathy tonight, folks. Just kidding. Anyway, I just thought I'd bring you up to date with where we're up to here. All right, so this next song is going to be from our latest album, which is called Flowers in the Dirt. And this song is called We Got Married. Team. You having a good time? Okay, we're gonna go back now through the mists of time. Towards an era known as the 60s.
Thank you.
So yeah, so I'll tell you what, listen, everybody say after me, say to me, oh yeah! Say, all right!
All right!
Say, okay!
All right!
Say, Masa Salamusulu, Vila Savilino, Tatsin Heya! A little bit of a bop, fancy dancing around a bit. Yeah? Okay, well, this next song we're gonna do, it's a pretty good one to dance around to. Instrument changeover.
Yeah.
Chicago.
Yeah.
Lights up the rice in the church where the wedding was being. Lives in a dream, waits at the window, wearing the face that she keeps in a jar by the door.
This song is guiding.
Okay. Thank you, folks. Yo. Great pleasure tonight for us to be in the same room as you. That song is called This One. And this next one is also off our latest album, Flowers in the Dirt. It goes like this. Thank you.
Yeah.
Send to Chicago when we pass. Okay, listen, if there are one or two of you out there who still got, like, that much energy left. Well, you might want to use it up on this next song we're going to do, which features our smashed-up drummer, young master Christopher here, and he's going to do his best for you on a song which is called Coming Up. Thank you. McCartney at the end of the show. We just wanted it, right? You still having a good time? Okay, then, let me just say something here. You know, when you came in, I think you got given a free program. Can you tell me? I'll tell you about it. Listen, the idea is that on these concerts we're doing, we're giving a platform to these people called the Friends of the Earth. Right? So, the idea is, take a look at the program, there's an article that explains it. Go home, have a think about it. If you get a chance to vote, tell your politicians we want to live in a clean world, okay?
Yeah.
Pay fingers. There'll be prizes given out for anyone who spotted the deliberate mistake in that one. Okay, now listen, when I was down in New Orleans many years ago, I'll tell you, what it was, I met Fats Domino, the fat man, yeah? Fats Domino. Yeah. And he said to me, he said, Paul, he talks like that. He said, Paul. I said, yeah, Fats. That's the truth. Can I tell you a lie? He said, Paul, he said, you make me cry. This is a cassette that Roger Moore sent us.
Changing world in which we live in. Take a sad song Thank you. Yeah.
All right, I'd like to introduce you to my wife, Gertrude Higgins.
Woo! It's been a long and winding road, but a living legend is here in the Chicago area tonight. None other than Paul McCartney, the singer and songwriter, guitarist. And as our Mark Schaefer reports, the ex-Beatle is bringing back some timeless memories.
Yesterday and today are meeting at Rosemont Horizon. Paul McCartney and his band opened the first of a three-night stand here in Chicago. Plugging his new album, Flowers in the Dirt, critically acclaimed as one of his best albums in years, if not a bestseller, the fans at Rosemont came to hear a, and there are very few people who really fit this term, a living legend.
Scalpers have been asking $500 a piece for McCartney tickets. It's the first time he's toured here in the U.S. in 13 years. And before that, when he was here with the Beatles, tickets went for $5.50.
Chapman was ordered sent to Bellevue Hospital.
It's all history now, or is it? On his new album, Paul collaborated with Elvis Costello.
Take me to that place. That's really like me and John.
Take me to that place.
And I did say to Elvis, we've got to really be careful about that, you know, but I mean, you can't be too careful, can you?
Paul McCartney has been very careful about his song list tonight for this concert. It's still going on. He's doing a last encore, and it's absolutely been amazing. I mean, I've been to concerts, but I've never seen anything like this. It's unbelievable that a man could hold 17,000 people in the palm of his hand. But when you look at the songs he's been playing, it's Back in the USSR, Maybe I'm Amazed, Stopped Everything, Hey Jude, Here, There, and Everywhere, Fool on the Hill, Saw Her Standing There, Live and Let Die, Went Nuts. I mean, it's been an amazing evening. I've stood there watching this man. There's not a lot of pyrotechnics. It's just one man and this incredible music that's lit up a generation. It's absolutely incredible. Beg, borrow, don't steal, but do something to get here Monday and Tuesday. We'll have a more report tomorrow at 10 and also at 5. We're going to talk to Paul McCartney. Back to you, Mike.
All right. Thank you, Mark. I think he liked it. That's our news for Sunday night. Have a good week ahead. Good night, everybody.
Up next on the Channel 5 News, friends and supporters gather to mark the anniversary of two slain Chicago civil rights leaders. Then later, Paul McCartney's American tour makes it to Chicago. We'll be right back. Tonight, singer-songwriter Paul McCartney is kicking off a three-night stand at the Rosemont Horizon. Channel 5's Bob Surratt joins us from the Horizon with his observations on tonight's performance by the former Beatle. Well, what do you think?
Hey, I think the guy's got a future. I think he's found another good band. Jackie, the show just ended here at the Horizon, and we saw it all, really. Laser beams, fireworks, panels that rise up and down on the stage. We even saw a technical malfunction, a couple of blown fuses here, and they couldn't get that projector going at the beginning of the concert, so we didn't get to see the much ballyhooed Richard Lester film biography of Paul that starts off the concert. Tomorrow night, I'm sure they'll have it fixed. We did see a great show, though. Let's take a look at how it started 2.5 hours ago.
Yeah.
And here's some of the artwork we saw tonight. This is Sarah, who's 21. And how did you do this?
It's done in number 2 pencil and chalk, and it takes about 100 hours to do.
And what was the highlight of the concert? What was the best song tonight?
I liked My Brave Face, but I liked all
the new stuff. Yeah. See, now that's interesting, because thank you, Sarah. A very nice review. The biggest reaction tonight was when Paul mentioned the 60s on stage. But everybody had a great time, 15,000 plus here. Roger Daltrey in the audience, and tomorrow a press conference will cover it. Paul will announce some additional dates. Jackie?
And 2 more nights to see it, correct?
Yeah, 2 more at the Horizon here. Then he goes to Europe after a couple more dates in America.
Okay, thanks a lot, Bob Surratt. Well, that's all we've got tonight. Have a wonderful evening and a great week. Bye-bye, everyone.
Jim Rosenfield also tonight. President Bush and Mikhail Gorbachev do something that's never been done before as their summit at sea wraps up. And a very long wait is over for local fans of Paul McCartney. An expanded version of Eyewitness News is next.
Live from the NBC Tower, this is Channel 5 News, the complete midday report with Bob Surratt and Joan Esposito and Jim Hill with weather. The Channel 5 News at noon.
Still to come on the Channel 5 News at noon, doctors are optimistic about another historic transplant, this one heart, kidney, and liver.
And we will take you back to last night and show you some of Paul McCartney's concert and a chat with one of the Chicago celebrities who got a ticket.
And we'll talk to the man known as the father of aerobics next on the Channel 5 News at noon.
One more thing now about opening night last night for Paul McCartney in Chicago. I thought we'd find out what one of the celebs in the crowd thought about the concert. Unfortunately, I could not get Roger Daltrey to come into the newsroom today, so since you were sitting in front of me, what did you think?
I thought it was one of the top 2 concerts I've ever seen.
What's the other one?
When I had 4th row seats for Bruce Springsteen.
Ah.
It wasn't like a concert. It was like the last 20 years of your life. He does about 60-70% Beatles songs.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. When he toured last year in 76 with Wings, he didn't really do a lot of Beatles stuff. And now he's come to terms with that. He does it, and that electrifies the crowd. And also, and I said this to you last night, when he toured in 76, John Lennon was still alive, so you thought, this is exciting, but one day the Beatles
will get back together.
Right, that's the fantasy. And now that will never happen, you're looking at the closest thing you will ever get to a Beatles concert, Paul singing.
Exactly, and the harmonies are fabulous. They're just fabulous. It really, you can shut your eyes. They did Can't Buy Me Love. You could shut your eyes. It sounds like the Beatles. I turned around. Your wife has tears running down her face.
A lot of crying, men and women. Here's a little bit of the way the show started with one of his new songs, Paul at the Horizon.
Stick good together of each other. A boy slipping back. I'm just straightened down. Better my body getting stuck in a figure of eight. Oh, figure it out for yourself, little girl. I'm going nowhere at all. Nothing more than
makes no bones about doing the new album stuff at the end of the show. He just kind of weaves it in early, and then it's just the Beatles and everybody goes nuts.
He sounds great. He looks great.
Yeah, and we'll have more coming up later today on Channel 5 and also at 10 tonight. He's got a press conference we'll be covering, so we'll see what he has to say.
It was wonderful.
Well, I'm glad we found a celebrity to interview. We'll see you tomorrow. Have a nice day.
Love each other, a boy slipping back. I'm just straightened down. Better my body getting stuck in a figure of eight.